Dremmy Day on Nesson is presented by Jordan's Furniture and by Sovereign Bank.
And we're all highly talented, active, and committed members of the SHS Music Department. Welcome Sarah Gaudu, Dan Moniz, Matt LaRose, and Melody Watkinson. Thank you. And now taking over from the field in our celebration of Jerry Remy Day is his partner in the broadcast booth, Nesson play-by-play commentator, Don Orsillo.
Thank you very much, Carl Bean. We're here to pay tribute to a man who has been part of your daily Red Sox TV experience for more than two decades now. Jerry Remy has been recognized with four Emmy Awards, written a book, and been elected as the first president of Red Sox Nation. To help us celebrate his excellence for 20 years in the broadcast booth, we have some special guests who are here tonight. His on-air colleagues at Nesson, Andy Brickley, Hazel May, John Chandler, Catherine Tappan, Eric Fried, Jamie Parker, Heidi Watney, and Tom Caron. Members of the management team at Nesson, President Sean McGrail, and Vice President of Programming and Production, Joel Feld. His Nesson broadcast partner for 7 years, Bob Kurtz. His broadcast partner for 9 years, and the man who gave him the nickname Remdog, Sean McDonough. The chairman of the Red Sox, Tom Werner. And team president and CEO, Larry Lucchino. His most influential coach and very close friend, please welcome Walt Riniak. His teammate for 7 seasons, Red Sox Hall of Famer, Dwight Evans. His teammate and double play partner for 3 seasons, Red Sox Hall of Famer, Rick Burleson. His teammate for 7 seasons, now a Nesson colleague, Red Sox Hall of Famer, Jim Rice. his teammate for just over six seasons, and now a Nesson colleague, Hall of Famer Dennis Eckersley. His teammate for three seasons, Hall of Famer Carlton Fisk. His wife, Phoebe, his daughter, Jenna, and his sons, Jordan and Jared. And now the man of honor, Nesson color analyst and my broadcast partner, Red Sox Hall of Famer, the Rem Dog, Mr. Jerry Remy. Jerry, now that you're comfortable in that chair, it's time to show everyone why we've gathered here tonight to honor you. Please direct your attention to the video board in center field as we look at the impact you've made on the sports broadcasting industry over the last two decades.
Hi, Lenny Clark here, celebrating 20 years of serious broadcasting with Jerry Remy and the Boston Red Sox. All business, all the time. A no-nonsense guy, and I'm going to prove it to you people at Fenway here tonight. Do you remember some of these?
Hello, New England's the Rem Dog.
Nesson presents Boston Red Sox baseball.
Tonight, the Red Sox take on the Chicago White Sox.
The Twins are far and away right now leading the AL Central, and they've been outstanding this season, Jerry.
I'm working with a man who wears makeup.
I'm heading out tonight, baby. Gyro ball.
You are something else. You look terrific.
Get that thing out of here. I don't want to see this camera on here anymore. You are good. That's why you are who you are.
What did I tell you? All business, all the time. Keep rocking for another 20 years, Jerry. We love you.
Jerry, a lot of things have happened over the years that have been pretty funny, but what is the lightest moment for you?
Oh, Don, it's hard to tell. There have been so many fun times in the booth. You know, not every game's a great game, so sometimes we have to have a little fun. But the one that sticks out in my mind is when Lenny Clark was up there, he's just absolutely hysterious when he took off on Mel Gibson that night. That had to be one of the highlights.
Well, as you just saw, being a broadcast partner of yours affords plenty of laughter. Each of the men you've worked with also knew they'd have to share the booth with you and Wally. And to clear a path, as soon as the broadcast is over, to get out of your way as you try to get to the exit as quick as possible. Here's a look at the four main men you've shared the booth with, beginning with the late, great Ned Martin.
And my pleasure, of course, to have as my new partner, number two, Jerry Remy.
There it goes, long shot left field. And see you later, home run. 2-0, Red Sox.
Hello.
Up on the line. Minnesota right now leads the series 4-3. Kevin Kennedy folding no punches.
Can you see?
I can't close my right eye.
Oh.
Without holding it.
Hello, friend.
Hello, friend.
It's really good to see you once again. Hello.
For the first time since the beginning of spring training, Grady Little has really named Brandon Lyon and
the other guy. Jerry, I know Ned Martin was your first partner. Your memories of Ned?
Well, I know right now Ned is looking down from above, and he was my first partner and one of the classiest men I've ever met in my life. And I know if he's looking down right now, he's probably saying, how in the heck did you make 20 years? But I've been very fortunate to work with tremendous people. Bob Kurtz, one of the nicest guys I've ever met in my life. We had a heck of a lot of fun together. Sean McDonough, who of course nicknamed me the Rem Dog, and really, I thought, in my opinion, brought the very best out of me as not only an analyst, but also to learn how to have fun in the booth. Thank you, Sean. And you. This is still an ongoing story. But Ned, if you're looking down, thank you very much.
No matter who your partner is, the one thing viewers receive each telecast is an analyst who is genuine, knowledgeable, and one of them, a New Englander and a fan. You also seem to have a knack for seeing things before they actually happen.
Cal Crawford was way down that third baseline, and Johnson working out of the wind-up position. I'd be very leery of that. Now look where Crawford is, and he was thinking about it. He really was. And here he comes.
Here he comes. No chance. Trying to steal home, and he does. Cal Crawford.
I thought he was going the first time, Don. I really did. I want you to watch Manny's front foot on this, and it'll tip off to you that he's looking for a ball that's down and in. Watch how he leaks a little bit. That front foot's going to go a little toward third base. That tells me that he's definitely looking for the ball down and in. And when he gets it in that area, that's when he does some damage. Now watch this area here, how he comes down a third baseline with it. He'll open up. That means he's looking for a ball down and in. And when he gets it like that and he's looking for it, that's when he can really crush it.
Jerry, we'd like to congratulate you on this special day, Jerry Remy Day, here in Boston and at Fenway Park, and thank you for two decades of excellence.
Thank you very much, Don. Thank you. Well, for somebody who was born in Fall River, grew up in Somerset, Massachusetts, and have a chance to be here as not only a baseball player but a broadcaster, this is a magical mystery ride I'm on, and I'm enjoying every second of it. I'd first of all like to thank Nesson for giving me an opportunity 20 years ago and really taking a chance to give me a second career after baseball. And also my Nesson colleagues who work very hard to give you the best possible sports coverage they possibly can. I would also like to thank the Boston Red Sox organization. From the old regime to the new regime, here as a player and now as a broadcaster, I really feel like I'm part of a Red Sox family over the last 30 years. For my family who is here tonight, thank God my wife has put up with me for 33 years. I don't know how she's done it. And there's some very special teammates behind me, all either Red Sox Hall of Famers or Hall of Famers that are in Cooperstown. We have Carlton Fisk, Red Sox Hall of Famer, Cooperstown. Rick Burleson, Red Sox Hall of Famer. Walt Reniak, my favorite coach and my best friend. Dennis Eckersley, Red Sox Hall of Famer, Hall of Famer in Cooperstown. And Jim Rice, Red Sox Hall of Famer, and Cooperstown Hall of Famer next year. And on the other side, the guy that patrolled right field better than anybody that's ever put on a Red Sox uniform, Dwight Evans. And last, I would really like to thank the fans, the Boston Red Sox fans, and Red Sox Nation for accepting me into your homes for the last 20 seasons. I hope to be in your home at least for 20 more. Thank you.
I At this time, I would like to introduce the president of NESN, Mr. Sean McGrail, who will present Jerry with a very special gift.
Jerry, it's hard to believe you've been with NESN for 20 years. And most of us at NESN and Red Sox Nation still remember your first broadcast. No, and actually, we feel very privileged to have been able to experience it for over two decades. So thank you very much for everything you've done for us. We wanted to get you something special, something that you'd remember this night by. So we reached out to our friends at the New England Ford dealers because we wanted to get something that wasn't already for sale on your website tonight. And that was a difficult task. So we reached out to John Sawyer and Andrew Frick. Please come up, gentlemen, from New England Ford. And John and Andrew helped us go through all the products of Ford and pick out something appropriate. And given that we're a sports network, in the end, we picked a sports car. So from all of us at NESN, thank you for everything. And I hope you really enjoy this 2008 Mustang GTT convertible. So I hope you enjoy bringing this to Fenway every day and continuing to speak to the fans of the Red Sox and Red Sox Nation on NESN for many years to come. Thank you again.
Thank you, Sean. Now we welcome Jerry to the pitcher's mound for tonight's ceremonial first pitch. His former teammate and Hall of Famer Carlton Fisk will handle the catching duties. All right, Remdog, how about a pitch? And now to conclude our tribute to Jerry's two decades of Red Sox color commentary, a very special guest. Jerry's grandson, Dominic, is here to say the two words we all love to hear.
Play ball!
Play ball.